So hi everyone, in this video we will be covering the admin panel that we have for this out of the box food delivery solution, along with the merchant panel which all your restaurants would be using. So let's start with this video now. So this is the admin dashboard that we have, and this is the landing page for the same. So over here the first option is for the dashboard, and as you can see it gives you a 360 view of the entire platform. So over here you can see the number of pending orders, what are the number of active orders on the system, how many orders have been delivered, how many orders were cancelled by the customers, if you are running any promotions, so what is the total number, how many food items are there, what are the total number of categories and restaurants on your system itself. So going below, we have the graphical representation of revenue and orders. So this is actually very helpful tool in order to determine how the business is going, in order to understand the dynamics of your business. For example, you can see that for May 7th, this is the total revenue that you had generated, and on the same date, you know, you had 16 orders placed. So you can just compare this data with previous reports and analyze your business whether it's expanding exponentially up or not. So you can just apply that filter over here and see the data by yourself. So it's actually a very important feature for the admin to monitor the business dynamics. And then below that we have different options for orders. So we have a bucket which contains all the pending orders and a bucket which contains all the active orders. So we do provide this option to the admin to accept and reject the order in case the restaurant is not doing that. So basically this is actually a very helpful tool for the admin to monitor the performance of their vendors. So in case he sees large number of pending orders, he can definitely take an action against that particular restaurant and even block him, since the acceptance rate for that particular restaurant is quite low. So it's actually giving the authority to the admin to just keep track of everything and see how the business is going. So even, you know, the admin can just click on this confirm order and add the preparation time over here and just do it instead of the restaurant itself, and the order will automatically move into the active bucket. And in case you know, the admin wants to see the overall details related to that particular order, so he can just click on this option and he can see the details regarding it over here. As you can see, the status is confirmed. This is the complete customer bio over here, what was the order that the customer had placed and what the total price. So that's how the admin can monitor the complete details regarding the order. The second option that we have is for the menu. So over here, the admin can create different business categories that he wants to have on the system. So as you can see, these are the different cuisines that we have: Asian, Mexican, Italian, Russian, North Indian, South Indian. So you can have as many cuisines altogether on the platform. And in order to add these you know, business categories, the admin can just click on this plus option and specify the details over here, you know, what's the name, if there is some kind of tax percentage on that cuisine, and specify the description as well, and also specify the website and the application image. So if the admin wants to go back, he can just click on this option and he can see, you know, the complete business categories that he's running on the platform itself. So that's how it works. Going further under the category, so let's assume I select the Asian category and I want to add different products within that particular category. So over here I will have to select Asian, and then under Asian I'll have to add subcategories. So I can just click on this plus sign and add those subcategories. So as you can see, it's a complete hierarchy that is generated in the system. First you have categories, and then within the category you have subcategories, and within the subcategories you have your final products. So that's how it works. Now this is the business category, this is the menu, and then within a particular menu you have the food item. So under poke bowls you will be having different food items, and that's how you can just configure it. The third option that we have, it's for the restaurants. So over here you have a complete database of all the registered restaurants altogether on the platform. So if you want to add that particular, add a new restaurant, you can just click on this option and you'll have to specify the name, the email ID, what's the phone number, the address, you know, whether that particular restaurant is providing delivery or it's just self pickup or both, and your subsequent commission as well. And then you can assign different business categories to that particular restaurant. So once you specify the restaurant email over here, the restaurant would receive the credentials for this particular on his email. so that he can just sign up on the platform and set the catalog by himself. So that's how this works. And in order to know more details related to that particular restaurant, the admin can just click on this option and see the details, you know, what's the name, the address, phone number, how the delivery charges would be calculated. You can just set the base delivery charge, the delivery charges per kilometer, and then the delivery area. So this is another important feature to have in the system. So basically the admin can set the vicinity in which a particular restaurant would be serving. And again, this can be configured by the restaurant itself from the restaurant panel. But we provide this option to the admin to configure it too. So moving further, we have food items. So, you as an admin, you can just assign different business categories to that restaurant. And the restaurant can also just manage the catalog from the restaurant panel itself. Then we have ratings and review. So the admin can just view all the ratings and reviews that were given to the restaurant by the customers. And then we have the configuration. So over here, the restaurant can specify the preparation time, what's the minimum delivery time and what's the maximum delivery time. And the same would reflect on the customer application itself. So over here, the restaurant can set his availability. So, the restaurant can just specify that, yes, on Monday, he'll be working from this, from this particular time to this particular time. And in case he's not available on a certain day, he can just click on this particular toggle button and mark itself unavailable. So that's how this option works. Then we have drivers. So over here, the admin will have the database of all the drivers that are registered on the system. In case the admin wants to add a new driver, he can just click on this plus option and specify the access as well. So whether that particular driver would be serving for all the restaurants or whether he's belonging to a fleet of a particular restaurant. So you can just set the commission as well, which would be deducted on the delivery charges, and the rest would be transferred directly into the agent's wallet. So that's how this works. And in case the admin wants to see the fleet of drivers for a particular restaurant, he can just select that restaurant from here and see the details. And in case he wants to add some driver tip, he can do that as well. So he can just add the tips from here, and the same would reflect on the customer application. The next option is for the orders. So this has been covered already. So over here we have different filters as well. So in case you want to compare the number of orders with your previous month, you can just apply that filter over here and see the comparison and analyze the data. And in case you want to see the orders based upon payment type, you can do that as well. So moving further, we have banners. So as I had mentioned, this is the marketing tool which is enabled in our system. So you can have multiple banners altogether on the platform, and you can assign these banners to different restaurants. So let's assume you want to have a banner and you want to assign it to this particular restaurant, and you can specify the validity over here and what particular category that banner would be depicting. And this is actually another source of revenue for the admin, because there is a tendency that a customer would click on that banner and place an order from that restaurant. So the greater the number of orders, it will be a benefit for the restaurant. So the admin can also have an increased commission on each transaction for that particular restaurant. So that's how it's advantageous for the admin to have these banners. Then we have promotions. So over here, you can have multiple promotions altogether on your platform. In order to, just create a new promotion, you can just click on this option and specify the promotion details. Whether it would be a flat discount or a percentage discount, what should be the minimum basket value, who will be the promo bearer, whether it's admin or the restaurant, and what's the validity for that particular promotion code. So everything can be managed from the admin panel itself. Then we have users. So this is a complete database for all the registered customers on the platform. So the admin will have a complete access to this data as well. And in case the admin wants to download this data in a CSV format, he can just click on this button and he can just analyze the data. Then we have the option for sub-admin. So this is another unique feature to have on the platform. So basically, On this system, you can create a hierarchy of admin. So basically, there is the admin who is the entire god of the system. And then below the admin, you can have like assistant manager or associate manager, and you can assign different access, different permissions to those managers. So you can just see, what permissions you can assign. So for example, there is a marketing manager who is just taking care of, marketing. So you can just assign banners and promotions to that particular admin and give that access. So that's how the permission works. And in case you want to, just add these sub admins, you can just click on this add admin option and specify the credentials for that manager. Then you have the reporting section. So over here, we have four different types of reports. So the first one is user report, and you can see the complete details regarding the users and how many number of orders a particular user has placed. So this again helps you analyze the data. And in case you want to send some emails or push notifications to your customers, you can do that as well. So you can just select whether you want to send a pop-up notification or an email and send the content to your customer. So this is another unique feature which an admin panel needs to have, because let's assume there is a particular customer who is not placing the orders right now from your system. He's using some other kind of application. So you can just get that privacy and talk to that particular customer through this pop-up notification. You can just send some customized email to that customer in order to know the response and improve the business. So that's how this feature works. Then you have order report over here. So the admin can just monitor the complete reports. He can see the status for all the orders which were placed by the customer. You have the restaurant report. So you can have a complete database for the restaurant over here. You can see what's the commission that you are charging, how many orders have been delivered, and what's the revenue for that particular for that particular restaurant. And in case you want to download that data, you can do that as well. And then we have the driver report. So you can just see the complete report for all the delivery boys. You can see the name, the email ID, whether that particular driver is working for a restaurant, how many orders has he delivered, and what's his revenue. And in case you want to see the driver for a particular restaurant, you can just apply that filter from here. The next option that we have, it's for accounting. So the first option under accounting is for account statement. So you can see the transaction status for all the orders that were placed by the customers. So you can see the customer name is Sheetal. What is the order delivery date? What is the tax? What is the commission? What are the delivery charges? What's the total order amount? And what is the balance amount? And you can see the status as well. And in case you want to see the account statement for a particular restaurant, you can do that as well. You can just apply that filter and the same would reflect on the admin panel. And the next option that we have, it's for account settlement. So this is another unique feature using which the admin can just settle the payouts with different restaurants. So over here, the admin can see what amount he owes to restaurant for online orders and what is the amount the restaurant owes to the admin for the cash on delivery orders. And they can just settle the payouts on a weekly basis or a bi-weekly basis depending upon the requirements. And over here, if the admin wants to just see the status, payment status based upon received or outstanding, he can do that. He can do that as well. And if he wants to see, if he wants to clear the payout with a certain restaurant, he can just select that restaurant over here and apply the filter. So that's how, the complete settlement is done. The next option that we have, it's for the settings. And under settings, the first option that you see is for basic. So over here, the admin can just set the logo, the admin brand image, and he can also specify the color theme. What's the referral amount for receiver and for sender? What are the payment methods on the system? What is the waiting charge per minute? And you have the cancellation policy over here. So this actually works when a customer wants to cancel the order. And let's assume, the customer cancels the order when the order was pending. So in that case, you can have three events generated. You can have full refund for that particular status, you can have partial refund, or no refund at all. So you can just set these refund type for different statuses, and then you can set the placeholder images as well. The next option is for the default address, so you can just set the default address from here. The third option is for the terminologies, so in case you want to change the keywords or different terminologies on the application, you can do that easily. You just have to, in case instead of delivery boy you want drivers to appear on the application, you can just do that, and the same would reflect on the applications. So that's how it works. The next option that we have is for email setup. So over here the admin can just send some customized emails to users and restaurants. The next option that we have is for pop-up notification. So again, the admin can just push some content to all the users and restaurants depending upon the condition. So in case he's running some kind of discount, he can just push that content to all these users, and he can just select all the users by clicking on this option. The next option that we have, it's for terms and conditions, privacy policy, about us, and FAQs. So everything can be configured from this panel itself. The complete about us information for the company can be set from this particular option. The next option that we have, it's for payment gateway. So right now, as you can see, we have Stripe payment gateway integrated with the platform. But we can do any kind of integration depending, we have the open APIs for that payment gateway. So that's how this works. The next option that we have is for social login. So right now we just have Facebook, but in case you want to have Instagram or Google, we can do that as well. So this was the complete demonstration of the admin panel. Thank you.